when you're trying to build in a league like this. These teams up there aren't getting worse, so we have to get better. Hopefully you'll come back in a couple years and we'll be able to talk a little bit differently about where we are as a program, and I feel very confident that that's going to happen.
Good job. Yeah, good job. Good job. That boy Shaq, moving.
Steve, we changed the culture right away. I mean, you're going to hustle, you're going to rebound, you're going to die for loose balls. That's a Steve Peichel signature team.
Here you go. Here you go, Black.
I think every year we've been here, we've gotten better, and that's been my goal. We needed to upgrade a lot of things. The locker room, and the weight room. Now we're in the best practice facility, I think, in the country.
Investments in the program, the practice facility, $110 million, they have been everything because there's a building people can walk into and see, hey, Rutgers is serious about competing in big-time basketball.
Here we go, here we go.
Going into the year, we had a lot of newcomers. We only have 1 3-year player, Gio Baker. Everyone else is a first-year, second-year player. So we had a lot of pieces that we kind of had to mold together.
This year, I really saw something happening. After we had just lost to Pitt, just lost to Michigan State, and we could have called it quits right there. We could have put our head down. We could have sulked our way through the rest of the season. But instead, we picked our heads back up. We beat Wisconsin at the rack.
Tonight belongs to the Scarlet Knights.
And we beat CN Hall at the rack.
Rutgers has painted the Garden State scarlet.
I think we all were realizing we can do this. Like, we're just as good as anybody in the Big Ten, and we're going to prove it.
Rutgers hasn't made the NCAA tournament since 1991. They've had losing seasons dating back to 2006. That's a long time. And so the first goal was to change that and have a winning season. That's happening this season. The second goal, play in a postseason tournament. That's happening this season. The third goal, play in the NCAA tournament. And that's the carrot at the end of the stick.
Baker for three, and the lead, he had.
When I first took over the program, they were more surprised when we win. Now they're, you know, coach, you lost the game. I'm like, yeah, we're gonna lose some games in this league. I hope people just continue to realize that we're on a great journey here. Hopefully a lot of people will enjoy the ride. Quasi.
If you live in New Jersey or you are visiting New Jersey and you have never been to the rack for a college basketball game, put it on your bucket list.
Well, welcome to the GMC Finals here at the Rutgers Athletic Center.
They started playing New Jersey high school championship games here in the 1980s.
Morgan spins and fires.
And the honor roll of big-time players who've come through this place at a young age is awesome. Kyrie Irving, Karl Anthony Towns, Michael Kidd-Gilchrist, Jay Williams, the list goes on and on. The vintage moment in the rack is the 1989 Atlantic 10 tournament final.
Close game against Penn State, Ricky Dattica. He hits a jumper from the right corner to beat Penn State.
Dattica going for three. Woo! Rutgers goes to the NCAA. Look at the mock scene on the court.
The place, that's the loudest I've ever seen it.
People were just jumping on the bandwagon so fast it was about to derail. And that kind of feels like this season in a way. This Rutgers team has surprised a lot of people and the momentum is gathering fast. I feel echoes of 1989 and what's happening now. The rack is the perfectly named building. Because rack is a torture chamber, right? So opponents come in here and they get the worst.
Ugly, it's dysfunctional, it doesn't have enough bathrooms, but it's our place. And it sort of reflects in some ways the grittiness of New Jersey.
Oh, nice, baby, undefeated at home.
Last year I would get here like 40 minutes before they started letting people in, get my front row seat, that's all good. Today I got a lineup, an hour before that lineup time.
I love it. I love the shape of it. I love the noise that it creates.
It's not comfortable. People here are not coming here to hang out and lounge in a bar. They're not coming here to socialize. They're coming here to scream at the court and for their team and at the opponent.
Rutgers down by three with the ball as they have battled back from 18 down. Here's Baker.
Cut right, step back, three for the tie. Yeah!
The rec is just amazing. The way the rec is set up is just makes it really loud and compact, and we've caused a lot of excitement here.
Two-point game. Rutgers, I think, is going to have to score again.
Baker slides right, steps back. Dribble drive, step back, corner jumper, good! Rutgers comes back from 18 points down and beats Northwestern as they improve to 16-0 at home.
There's just an energy and an excitement that, you know, only a few places have, and it's just getting more and more exciting.
Wisconsin Badgers make the trek east to take on your Scarlet Knights. I break through the walls, I break through the chains, I'm moving along, but it's calling my name. Quarter three wide open, knocking it down, Montez Mathis. Timeout, Wisconsin. I give a damn what the rule is. I feel like I'm going insane. I feel like I'm about to lose it. Baker, one-handed feed to Johnson. Mathis, Yaboa, plays it in.
Wow.
How about Harper just ripping it away from the wall? Today is the dawn of a new. Baker gets to the rim. Underneath Johnson and the foul. 72-65 as Steve. Short with it. And now here's Rutgers going up top for an alley-oop to Ron Harper. Absolutely.
It's not their strength. Going to the basket is their strength.
Instead, here is a corner three and an air ball from Yaboa, but tapped out.
Rutgers hangs their hat on defense and rebounding.
Shot clock was winding down, and Baker knocks down. Back in, Aiko Biagu, and here comes Rutgers, and alley-oop Harper again! This time from Baker! McKnight with a turnover, Yaboa, they say he's great at getting the basket, but he proves it there, 9-0. Timeout, Seton Hall. Jared Roden, and then Kevin Willard is going to take the timeout.
Their aggressive nature has come to fruition.
And Rutgers has...
Yeah.
Kane is in the building.
Yeah! It's all right, already the show goes on all night. Till the morning we dream so. Anybody ever wonder when they would see the thunder? Just remember when you come up.
Up, I just laugh, put my kicks up on they desk, unaffected by they threats, then get busy on they ass. See, that's how that shot down made me, that's how my daddy raised me. That glittering may not be gold, don't let nobody play me. If you are my homeboy, you never have to pay me. Go on and put your hands up, when times is hard, you stand up. L.U.P. the man, cause a brand that the fans trust. So even if they ban, I still never slow my plans up.
just beats the clock.
Well, that's just way too easy.
This is a little different here on the road in Lincoln. Jacob Young doing stuff like that all night long.
Really good job of understanding once he turned the corner, the Texas transfer Jacob Young.
Career high for McConnell. As easily off the glass, he gets to the rim, and he'll go to the line for one more. Scarlet Knights has never won a game in Lincoln before. It's an exclamation point on their first win in the year.
What you been through, no matter what you into, no matter what you see, when you look outside your window, brown grass or green grass, picket fence or barbed wire, never ever put them down, you just lift your arms higher, raise them till your arms tired, let them know you there, that you struggling.
Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Space Jam. Here's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam. Alright.
Again, Mathis taps back his own miss.
He is all over the glass.
Harper's their leading scorer. He's going to get a screen.
From Johnson. Drives in on Watkins. Wow, what a reverse by Ron Harper Jr. Totally different game now. Mulcahy to a wide open Kwasi Yeboah.
Great execution against the press. You're right about that.
Jones no good. Dredd keeps it alive. Off to the other Jones. Myron Jones for three. McConnell trying to no look.
Come on and slam and welcome to the jam. Come on and slam. You want a jam. Come on and slam and welcome to the jam. Come on and slam. You want a jam. Slam, bam, thank you, ma'am. Get on the floor and jam. Just slide from left to right, just slide.
see that. Baker. Chris Johnson! Another alley-oop! Has not turned it over in 20 minutes of play. I think it's Finney. Switch to defense. Baker with the hammer! He's feeling just fine! 1 minute to go.
Trying to answer.
I was taking it away initially.
It's Baker. Got it off and in. Now Baker, lob, Harper. And there's the exclamation.
I can't drive.
Cut to fit, it's me. Fit to cut the shit. Come juggle with me. Say every time.
Here come the hot sniper.
I'm the lyrical gangster. Dial emergency number.
Timeout. Johnson
contesting that shot again, and on the transition, Young can't finish. Johnson will.
Johnson on both ends, cleaning up the mess.
Woo! Cross with a little cross move.
Oh man, how about the hesitation to get the defender up out of his stance?
Kyle DeSumo was big in that game. He had 27 for Illinois in the win. Now 5 to shoot for Nebraska. A shot for Jervin Green.
Nice job. You saw 4 red jerseys going after the rebound there.
Green wants to take it again. A quick 5 points now for Green.
Auburn utilizing that inside pivot to create a little bit of space.
Here's Easley. Mack will take it and make it. Big shot, Cam Mack.
Needed to pass fake and then go low to Johnson.
6 turnovers this half for Rutgers. The strong take for Green, and they build on that advantage. Here's where this home court advantage may come into play. How big could this 6 player be here at the rack for Rutgers? Trying to make a comeback now. Yeboah for 3.
What a play by Yeboah.
8 to shoot. Mack has to pull for 3. He has brought it all in the second half.
More fundamental than foul shooting.
Mack with a floater. He still hasn't missed in the second half. Baker has his first bucket, was trying to hunt down another. Johnson gives him a second chance. Yeboah for the tie.
And it starts with Johnson.
A foul.
You got a foul. Especially if the guy's got a clear berth.
So far, no foul. Baker for 3. And the lead. He hit. Oh, with 1.1. Baker.
Catfish. Yeah.
Back.
All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind. I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building.
Greatness, 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 greatness. And man, that's greatness, greatness, greatness. I swear that's greatness, greatness, greatness. You look into my eyes, you can see what I see. If you can say the world won't be the same without me, then we call that greatness, greatness.
And that's a blessing. But wait a second. Look, while we on the subject, let me ask a question. What's the proper word for the fire that's inside of you? That makes you bring the hunger out, the key that puts the drive in you. That thing that makes you wanna hit, pick you up when you slip. The thing that makes you wanna grip and restart when you wanna quit. The winner when you bout to lose, showing when you bout to prove. And never fall back, what you call that, we call that
greatness, greatness, yeah, yeah. We call that greatness, greatness, yeah, yeah. Look into my eyes, you can see what I see. Say the world won't be the same without me, then you know that's greatness, greatness, yeah, yeah. We call that greatness, greatness, yeah, yeah. Step inside my shoes, take a walk where I've been. If they can say there'll never be another you again, then we call that greatness.
Ever wonder how the greats ever came great? I mean, really, what did they do? What was their mind state? See it from a different angle. Seem a little different, ain't it? Both had the same canvas, came up with different paintings. Tried to figure it out, hoping that they could linger on them. But it's out of reach and they just couldn't put their finger on it. Always want a CAT scan, an X-ray to try on them. Tell you one thing, you won't find a quitting side of them. Neither will you find it out. It's a million of them walking around. Same ones in the dream that Dr. King talked about. Ready just to change the world. Ready just to make their mark. Same brains from the minds that Tupac had tried to spark. And it's very clear they all gotta be winners. Cause the only way they can lose is when they give up. And when it comes to the pressures, it's another level. I swear, man, it's something special. We call that
greatness, greatness.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man. And a man's got to learn to take it.
Yeah.
James Harden step back that he's so good at. There it is.
Tying his career high for three.
Country gives Rutgers its first lead of the game.
Stevens, the leader of this team. Nittany Lyons down by two. Dredd for the lead! With a hand in his face and pitched up one. Harper wants to take Dredd himself. Yeboah with a contested three. It's on. Harrah boxes out, and it's over!
Exacerbated look on the face of Maryland coach Mark Turgeon after that possession.
Everything out of sync. Carter, and it is the senior. Hot senior night for the first bucket.
Well, you can tell both teams that they really haven't settled down as of yet.
Well, maybe that'll help. Another senior, Kwasi Yeboah.
Spirited conversation at halftime, and they've been the best team in the Big Ten since.
What a stop and pop by Jacob Young, so he's got five early. Young, the hot hand early, belongs to the junior from Houston, Texas. And a pass right through the hands of Eric Ayala. Young drops it, Mulcahy lays it in. No look pass inside, what a beautiful feed and the throw down from Jalen Smith.
Wow, Orsell playing the role of Anthony time. They were taking better care of the basketball, sharing the rock. Oh, where you going, son?
He says, I'm going right into the middle of the hoop. Terps a perfect 8-0 against Rutgers since both joined the conference. Shot clock at three, and Baker knocks down his first shot from 30 feet. You said it, Sorrell Smith is locked in defensively.
Yes, he is.
But Baker gets free by a screen and does the rest.
Man, that's pretty.
Cowan stops the 7-0 run with a blow-by. Great pass from Cowan. And then maybe an even better pass from Ayala to Jalen Smith.
Oh, that's a great execution on a set play that time.
Baker, he might as well patent that fadeaway. He's so good at it.
Got to get Cowan the basketball on the wing and allow him to break down the defense.
Or how about Eric Ayala from 5 feet behind the arc?
That's clutch.
Brad transfer from Stony Brook, born in Ghana, moved to England at age 9. Stony Brook and now Rutgers, he's well traveled.
So although Maryland has the ability to, this is gonna be an uphill battle for them, no doubt.
Their only loss to Michigan, the last home game. How about that spin move from Smith?
Teammates settled down, excellent job by Sticks.
Oh, no look pass! Baker dropping it off for Montez Mathis. Breather for Ron Harper and count the basket there. Wiggins flips it up and in and he'll head to the line. Okay, he tried to pass it over to Johnson. Got it back, found Yeboah.
Wow. What a...
Speaking of contact, and now here's Jacob Young. And somehow he slipped that in between the backboard and the hand of Jalen Smith. Baker can't knock it down. And then here comes Maryland.
Got numbers if they hurry.
That's a good man to lob it up to. Smith throws it down.
New Jersey's finest residents, World Wide West, calls it Dirty Jersey, affectionately.
Baker! The year that a member of the Big East, Connecticut, won the national championship. Cowan got up in the air, had nowhere to go with it. Rutgers with numbers. Mathis says, I'll do it myself. Here is Anthony Cowan giving it over to Ayala. And Maryland finally hits a three-pointer, just their fourth of the night.
Just fade away a little bit. Be able to get an open look.
Mathis! Wow! What a night for Montez Mathis!
Nick Smith has had some success. Might want to look at him as well.
Oh, he did it again. That's the same thing he did in the first half.
Oh, heck of a year.
Strong drive and finish by Sorrell Smith, so he can make it a 10-point game at the line. Baker had a tap free, but is able to get it across. Oh, wow. I was about to say bad decision, but the end justifies the means.
And then Smith, he's coming alive offensively for Maryland. Saying, hey, that might be my last opportunity. The crowd saying, what are you doing? But Rutgers gets it back. And now Young, he gets his chance at the rim. As Rutgers gets their biggest win of the season and gives their tournament resume a huge boost. And they will storm the court in Piscataway.
Baker has just been